This, asked Dr. Durie, is one of the frequently asked questions related to the COVID-19 infection. This is frequently asked question number three. The question is, because of the distribution of the COVID-19 virus infection, do I need to make changes to my myeloma treatment? And the answer to this is possibly yes. This is something that you should carefully discuss with your doctor. The recommendation is that you follow up with your doctor using telemedicine or certainly just using a telephone or email for communication rather than going into the clinic. We're very concerned that myeloma patients going into the clinic or particularly to the hospital could have an increased risk of exposure to the COVID-19 virus infection. And so, because there is a risk of possible infection, we need to adjust such that myeloma patients are being managed in the safest possible way. And so, one aspect to reduce clinic visits is to reduce the number of needed intravenous infusions. And so one safe thing that you can do is to defer or delay intravenous zometa bone treatment medicine. This can easily be skipped for 2 or 3 months safely. As far as IV medications such as daratumumab, this has to be discussed with your doctor. However, it could be that particularly in the maintenance setting, the number of intravenous infusions can be reduced. One thing that we know, which is quite decisive, is that we really do not want you moving forward with autologous stem cell transplant at this time. This is a complex procedure, which is normally quite safe, but there is a period of time when the blood counts are low and when we are waiting for the new stem cells to engraft. During this period of time, it would be particularly dangerous to have a COVID-19 infection, which could interfere with the graft recovery and really complicate the whole process. And so this is one of the more decisive recommendations to discuss carefully with your doctor. If you have recently had an autologous stem cell transplant, the follow-up needs to be managed as carefully as possible, watching out for possible infectious complications. And so the bottom line is that there are a number of modifications to your treatment that can be helpful to improve your safety, and it is crucially important for you to talk to your doctor and have a plan of action for the next month or two so that you really are both clear how things are going to be managed and possibly allowing you time to stock up on medicines that you need for those couple of months. So very, very important to contact by telemedicine, by telephone, by email, and have a plan of action with your doctor.